Good afternoon, everyone. I am L. Jayanthi and my colleague Mr. A. E. Narayanan, working as assistant professor in Periyar Maniammai University in Vallam, Thanjavur in Tamil Nadu. First of all, I would like to express our sincere thanks to the coordinators of this workshop for giving us opportunity to participate in this workshop. Now I'll tell you about our university. First, Periyar Maniammai College of Technology for Women was started in the year 1988 in Thanjavur, and it is the first women engineering college in the world, and now it is elevated as a university from 2007 onwards, and it is an interdisciplinary university. These are the UG programs running in our university: Information Technology, Computer Science Engineering, ECE, EEE, Civil Engineering, Architecture, Biotechnology, Petrochemical Technology, Mechanical Engineering. And in all these UG programs, first year students are learning computer programming and programming lab. It is common for all the students. And also in MSc Software Engineering and MCA also, first year students are learning computer programming paper. And totally 1,620 students are learning computer programming. It will be much useful to all the students by this workshop, and also the faculty handling this programming paper. And these are the PG programs running in our university: MPhil programs, MS programs, and PhD programs are running in our university. And coming to the computer programming syllabus, in the first unit, we cover the different components of computer: hardware, software, booting, installing and uninstalling the software, and the basic computer and computer programming, as algorithm, flowchart, design and so on, and internet services. And in second unit, we'll cover the structure of C program and the expression operators and the different types of control structures. And in the third unit, we'll be handling the different type of functions, recursions, and arrays. And in fourth unit, we'll handle the different types of pointers and the programs related to the pointers, and fifth unit will be covering the structures, unions and file handling. This is our computer programming syllabus, and all the first year students of all the UG programs are studying this paper. And actually we divide the five units into three phases: phase 1, phase 2, phase 3. And in phase 1 we cover first unit and half of the second unit, and in phase 2 we cover the remaining half of second unit and third unit, and in phase 3 we cover fourth and fifth unit. And regarding the examination pattern, students will write three phases exam: first phase 1 exam for 60 marks, phase 2 exam for 60 marks, and phase 3 for 60 marks. And all these marks will be added and reduced to 60 marks. And the remaining marks, that is, every student has to take seminar before the students in presence of some of the faculty also. And we will award 15 marks for the seminar presentation and 25 marks for other components. Faculty can decide any method to evaluate the performance of students for this 25 marks. The other components, maybe we can keep the class test, surprise test, or we can give the problem solving exercise, or we can give assignment. We can ask the students to write the programs and submit as assignment, or we can give a particular topic to the student, ask the student to search in the internet and make a paper presentation and submit, and we can evaluate that. Or we can have a group discussion. We can say a particular topic to the students and to have a group discussion, and we can evaluate the performance of the students. Or we can students can give paper presentation, or depending on the field survey, we can send the students to hardware or software company, and we can ask the students to prepare the report on the company they have met. And we can give objective type questions, or we can ask the students to prepare a report on the implant training. Actually, students has to go implant training at least for 10 days, or any other novel method. It depends on the faculty. We decide the other components method of evaluating the student's performance for 25 marks. That depends on the faculty. And regarding the practical examination, We conduct the practical examination two times, phase one and phase two. Phase one will cover 2/3 of the practical exercise and we award it for 50 marks. And phase two, we award for 25 marks. And the remaining 25%, the student has to do mini project, either individual or combination of 2 to 3 persons. And we faculty only evaluate the performance of the students for 25 marks with respect to mini project. And in question pattern, so students has to write 3-phase examination. Each phase examination will be awarded for 60 marks. In that part A, they have to write 10 2-mark questions for 20 marks. And in part B, 11th question will be, they'll have one choice and they have to write for 16 marks. And 12th question also will be asked for 16 marks with one choice. And 13th will be 8-mark question with one choice. And regarding the computing facilities, we have 1,200 computers with internet facility, Wi-Fi campus, and also we have lease line also. And we have 10 numbers of servers. And details are shown here. These are the configurations of servers we have. And all the software required for the conduct of lab exercise are loaded in the systems. And these are the software we have loaded in our systems. My friend will deal about the question papers.
Madam has covered most of the portions, I think, in the presentation portion. The last one is actually the model question paper. Since Madam, we have 3-phase examination. This is one of the phase two examination question paper. And the question paper actually is confined on some analysis question and problematics question only. And the question papers will be verified by one examination representative in each every department. He or she will be a senior faculty of the department. They will verify the question paper. And this one is the phase, third exam, it's the last phase examination. And for last phase examination, the student has to cover the last two units. As far as the lab exercises is concerned, first of all, the students have to go for a pre-lab sessions, because since the students, if the student has have not have much more exploration in computer programming lab, the student has to go this kind of pre-lab sessions, Word, spreadsheet, PowerPoint, and simple programs in C. And next, they will enter into the regular program, like this kind of program using operators and expressions, this kind of programs. And the total program sessions, the practice session is actually 45. And these are the experiments conducted in the first examination, the first phase examination. Yeah, these in other components of the phase examination, these assignments will be given by the course teacher during their coursework. That's all. All questions. Any questions on that?
How you could manage 45 sessions in a semester? Just said that 45 sessions.
Lecture hours as far as theory is concerned, theory purpose.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So 45 sessions in a semester, how could it is possible to have those many sessions?
Yeah, actually, as far as theory is concerned, the staff members has to take 4 hours per week, actually. This is considered, it's a 4-credit subject. Since it's a 4-credit subject, the staff member has to take 4 hours per week. Yeah, possibly if you collect, if you calculate that working hours of the semester, it will come around 45 hours.
We spend extra hours for weaker students.
Any more questions, please? Fine. Thank you.